Are you tired of scrolling down to the total row of your Excel table? In fact, you can put those totals anywhere you want, and still have your counts, sums, and other functions applied to just the filtered rows of your table data. In this video, I'm going to guide you through a four-step process that will help you move those totals above your data table instead of below it, so you can get the functionality you need without the scroll. The first step is to take notes on the totals you want to create, and it's the longest of the four steps. In particular, you need notes on the name of your data table, the way that Excel references column names in its own version of the total row, and the special way you need to specify which functions you want to use for those column totals. To make sure we're all on the same page, I'm going to walk you through this bit by bit. In the description of this video, I've also got a link to a downloadable PDF you can print out for these notes, or just use as a reference guide. We'll start with the table name. The easiest way to get this, especially if it's a long name, is using the View tab of the ribbon. In the Show group, select Navigation, which should pull up a navigation pane on the side of your worksheet. There, you'll see a list of the worksheets in your workbook with the worksheet you're currently on expanded. Next to a little table icon that indicates an Excel table, you'll see your table's name. Write that down exactly, including any underscore characters. If it's a really long name, you might need to adjust the width of the navigation pane in order to see the whole thing. With that done, all of the rest of the notes you need for this step will be for the particular totals you want in your total row. And for these, we'll use Excel's own total row as our guide. If you don't already have the table's total row turned on, start by selecting the Table Design tab in the ribbon. If you don't see that tab, select any cell of your table to make it appear. In the Table Style Options group of the Table Design tab, check the Total Row checkbox. That will turn on the total row, and if your table is long, Excel should also scroll you down to the bottom of the table so you can see the total row. Now, for each of the columns you want totals for, click into that column's total row and use the drop-down list there to select which function you want to apply to that column. If you look at the formula bar after you've made your selection, you'll see that Excel has inserted a corresponding subtotal function into this cell. You're going to create a variation of this when you move your total calculations above the table, which is where your notes come in. Write down the two arguments in this subtotal function, the number and the column name. The number tells Excel which function you selected from the total row drop-down list. That'll be something like 103 for count or 109 for sum. These are special versions of count, sum, and the other functions in the total row drop-down list that only include visible rows in their calculations, which is why they change in response to your filters. The column name, in brackets, is how Excel knows that you want to apply this function to this column of table data. If you've tried typing these in manually before and gotten an error, take note of any extra punctuation Excel might have added, such as apostrophes in front of hashtag characters. Once you've taken your notes for each of the columns you want to work with, turn off Excel's version of the total row by unchecking the total row box in the Table Style Options group of the Table Design tab of the ribbon. Step two of our process is to make room for the new total row, by which I mean you need at least one blank row above your data table, because this is where the new total row is going to go. Scroll up so you can see the worksheet row that contains your table headers, and move your cursor over the row number so that it looks like a thick black arrow pointing directly at those headers. Next, right-click and select Insert. That will insert a blank row above your data table. You can insert as many blank rows as you'd like, but you only have to have one. For step 3, you're going to create a modified version of the subtotal function using your notes from step 1. I'll assume you want each of your total functions directly above the associated column, just like they used to be directly below the column when they were in Excel's version of the total row. So, for each total value you want to include, scroll over to the appropriate column, and in the cell above the column header, in that blank row we created in step 2, type in your new subtotal function. Using your notes from step 1, that will read something like equal sign, subtotal, open parenthesis, the number of the function you want to use, such as 103 for count or 109 for sum, comma, the name of your table, followed immediately by an open bracket, the column name, and a close bracket, and close parenthesis. So it's very similar to the subtotal function you'd get in Excel's version of the total row, but because you've moved this function outside of your table, you now need to insert that table name along with the column name. That helps Excel know exactly where to look for your data. When the subtotal was inside your table, in Excel's version of the total row, that table name was assumed. For step 4, we're going to do a little interface cleanup. Because this total row is now in a non-standard place, above your data table instead of below it, the first thing you probably want to do is add a totals label in that row. Mimicking Excel's version of the total row, you can put that over the leftmost column of your data table and bold it so that it stands out a little bit. You probably also want to annotate each of your total numbers with a note, comment, or other label that lets people know what this number is. For this video, I'll just add some quick labels in the cells around my new totals. Next, apply any number formatting you want to use on those totals by right-clicking on the cell containing your new total, selecting Format Cells, and applying whichever format makes sense for your data. Finally, you probably want to do a little functionality cleanup. Assuming you put the total row above the data table because you want to make sure it's always visible, even when you scroll, you can freeze panes. To do this, make sure you're scrolled up so that you can see your column headers and the first row of data. If you have any filters turned on, turn those off now. Move your cursor over the row number of that first row of data so that it looks like a big black arrow pointing at the row, and left-click to select that entire row. From the View tab of the ribbon, from the Window group, select Freeze Panes and Freeze Panes again. Now when you scroll down, you'll see that the new total row and your column headers remain visible. So, to recap, we've now replaced Excel's version of the total row, which was below the table, with our own total row at the top of the table by following the 4-step process of taking notes, making room, creating the totals, and cleaning up the interface. If this general information video did not solve your Excel table problem, or you'd like other help working with data in Excel, drop a comment below or find me, Barbara Olsavsky, the owner and data strategist at Blou Designs LLC, on LinkedIn or at bluedesigns.com. Thank you for watching.